Senator Clinton operates.
A representative at the Associated Press says the publisher of the memoir has been in touch with the wire service to object to their early publication. The AP says, we disagree completely with their legal conclusions of our story. We'll have more on both Hillary Clinton and Martha Stewart a little later in the broadcast, including a look at how the late-night comics are dealing with both of these women in the news. In Sydney, Australia, it is being called one of the biggest parties and one of the biggest marketing exercises the city's ever seen. The trio of actresses from Charlie's Angels has taken their worldwide promotional tour to Australia. Stacey Galani reports. The globe-trotting, crime-fighting, heavenly threesome have landed again. Australia, where they were met by a throng of media and a horde of frenzied young fans, some shedding tears in sheer excitement. Lucy Liu, Drew Barrymore, and Cameron Diaz were down under to promote Charlie's Angels full throttle.
The party was great. We had really fun nights at the end of
strong. Is it fun day after all?
Let me give you a feeling for what we're going to do. We'll try to keep the after-dinner ceremony short here. What I'm going to do is have a very short ceremony where I'm just going to hand the four awards to the awardees. And then we're going to have a few words from the chairman of the meeting, Gustavo Fuentes, who's going to just recognize people who contributed to the meeting. There is a person here from the ICC who will say a few words about the Paris meeting, and then Ann Gaffney will say and conclude the evening with a few words about the Philadelphia meeting. And then we have dancing afterwards. Okay, so I think most of you know that the North American Talents Society provides four awards over a period of every 2 years. These four awards, the recipients receive different amounts of an honorary stipend, and they have different expectations associated with that. All that information is on the website. For those of you who want to read more about that, you can read it there. All I want to do tonight is I will just read the recognition that's on each of the plaques and present the plaque to the company who is sponsoring the award, who will then present it to the awardee. We'll pause for a few minutes for those friends who may want to take some pictures, and then we'll go on to the next awardee. So in principle, it should only take a few minutes. Okay? So, the first award that we want to present today is the 2003 Eugene J. Boudry Award in Applied Catalysis. This award is sponsored by Soup2Me Incorporated, and it goes to Abelino Cuomo Canas. For those of you who may not tell what's happening up here, is sponsored by Johnson Matthey PLC. It goes to Professor Alex T. Bell. The award is given to Alex for his substantial contributions to one or more areas in the field of catalysis, with emphasis on discovery and understanding of catalytic phenomena, catalytic reaction mechanisms, and the identification and description of catalytic sites and species. Bill Cameron and Johnson Matthey are going to be very good.
Great talks, actually. We made some arrangements in the room. meeting to be sure that there would be at least tomorrow. So please don't forget that. That's just the beginning. I mean, I know that the attraction of the beach is really important. Please. Well, first of all, I wanted to, on behalf of the organizing committee, to thank all of you for being here. Without you, the interest that you showed in this meeting, it wouldn't be a success. So by attending the conferences and not spending too much time on the beach and the different places that we have around here in Cancun, you really helped us make a success, and we thank you for that. We also apologize for any inconveniences that some of you had in getting to Cancun. Actually, we tried our best to really make your trips and your coming here to Cancun as easy as possible, but some things went beyond our control. And for that, we apologize, but we are sure, and I want to thank most of the members in the committee for their help in pulling this through. We also want to thank the awardees, the keynote speakers, and the oral and poster presenters. We really were fortunate to have a really large number of first-rate presentations that were always thought-provoking and that we all enjoyed. And we want also to thank you for that. We want to thank also some guys and companies that actually were very important for us. We want to thank our sponsors. Really, the support of our sponsors was crucial in different points of our organization in pulling the meeting through. And their logos are there, and I don't want to go through all of them. But it was really important, and that helped us finally give to all of you the best that we could in terms of the meeting. In terms of the organizing committee itself, we want to thank our institutions in Mexico that really were also a great help in giving support, sometimes financial support, but many times just by giving charitable and organizational support in getting that. So I want to thank that, and I want to thank Academia de Catalysis, the local Catalysis organization in Mexico, for the support that they gave to the community for that. In terms of the North American Catalysis Society, well, all of the members of the committee helped one way or another by criticizing or giving some suggestions. We were in close contact with John Byrne, that unfortunately is not here, but who was very important in terms of the financial support of NACS and to us, and in helping navigate through some of the crises that we had in terms of the funding. John Armour, in particular, was, as you all know, a constant source of information and pressure to get things through. He was able to share some of his knowledge of Cancun and the environment, even by writing some notes that some of you may have heard, and he's actually copyrighted as far as I know. Characteristics that we may have here in Mexico, and that, but nonetheless, I think we managed to get a really nice and fruitful interaction with him, and we thank him for his support too. Finally, really the organizing committee of this North American meeting was a pleasure to work with. We managed to really get team effort throughout this whole event. It took us obviously a number of years to get to this point, and you say that, although the real hard work was at the very end. I would like them to stand up, and then I will ask for a round of applause for all of them. First of all, I want to thank Julia Aguilar, who was the charge of the
behalf of Dr. Michel Bress, who is the chairwoman of the next ICC meeting, and she apologized because she couldn't be here. So on behalf of her, I will present you the next ICC meeting. So I guess you have already found the second circular, which was deposited on the tables close to the session rooms. So the next ICC, the 13th one, will be held in Paris, as you know. And it will be held between 11 and 16th of July. So it means that 14th of July, which is our national day, will be included during your meeting. So I guess there will be a special event for that. And so this meeting, as you know, is organized by the International Association of Catalysis Societies and also by the Catalysis Division of the Société Française de Chimie. And it will be held in Paris in the Palais des Congrès. The Palais des Congrès is located on the east part of Paris at Porte Maillot, so it's the gate of Paris. And it's rather close to the Arc de Triomphe and Champs-Élysées. You can be there within 10 minutes by subway. And there will be three amphitheaters and for a maximum of 1,800 participants. And there will be all the rooms will be located at the same floors in order to favor exchange between people and during the different session. And on the same floor, so there will be a large room for poster exhibition and also for material exhibition. And what I want to point out is the key dates. So first, the first key date will be the abstract submission, which will start on September 15, between September 15 and November 5th. And you will be notification of acceptance. I hope for you for our presentation or keynotes before March 2004. And the deadline for early bird registration will be on April, 1st April of 2004. And I would like also to point out the fact that the abstract submission will be done directly on the website, and you will have to prepare two types of abstract, a two-page abstract for selection and a half-page abstract, which will be included in the book of abstract, which will be given for the Congress. And after the Congress, you will receive a CD including all the abstracts and also the notes of the different discussion which will be done during the different session. Okay. So at this Congress there will be 8 plenary lectures, and you can see the name of the different people who have been selected. And there will be award lectures also, about 10 keynote lectures, 120 oral presentation of 30 minutes long, so it means 20 minutes of presentation and 10 minutes of discussion. And then a session with 600 posters. I want also to inform you that there will be prize for young scientists, which means that they have to be below 35 and they have to attend to the conference, of course. And if they are selected for this prize, their fees will be reimbursed and they will have a certificate. And the last thing that I wanted to tell you is that before and after the Congress, several Congress are organized. One in Lyon, the third international symposium on calorimetry and thermal effect in catalysis. So the organizer is Ali Nohu. The second pre-congress symposium will be held in Poitiers and organized by Daniel Dupré, so it's Isotopes in Catalysis Studies. And the third one is not really a congress symposium, but it's a visit of the IRC, which is the Institute of Research and Catalysis in Lyon, and also the IFP, the French Petroleum Institute, which will be located in Lyon. As a matter of fact, they are now moving from the part which were located in Paris, is now moving to Lyon, so you will have the opportunity to visit in Lyon the both institute if you are interested in. And after the congress, there will be a symposium concerning in situ and operando spectroscopy for catalysis in Caen, and this meeting is organized by the new director of the laboratory of catalysis of Caen, who is Christian Carantos. So I will be Michel West, and everybody, every organizer will be pleased to receive you and to have you in Paris next year, and I hope the ICC will be as successful as this last year.
Website
site, which is all important, is managed by Alan Algar. Steve Jacobson is our works representative. Cocos Award is being organized by Jing Wong Chen with the, and also Israel Watts. Exhibitors Robert Wunder and advisor Leo Manzer and DuPont. And our technical program is taking shape. I'd like to highlight some possible areas here, as you can see. And we'll be heading up our chairs and looking for assistance in these areas. Finally, here's our hotel, Franklin Plaza. And we'll be the only organization in the meeting during that week in the hotel. And just to advertise a little bit about the area, there's lots of history here. The Liberty Bell, the Vincent's Hall, and lots of places for touring. And probably have a 5K race, so I recommend people to start it and shake the train. We're going to start in front of the Philadelphia Museum of Art. We're going to finish by racing up and down the stairs and, you know, the Milwaukee movie here. Thanks a lot, everyone.
I would like to thank you for being here.